So here we are doing two changes. What are the two changes? Expansion, making the axe head to become bigger, and contraction, making it small. Expansion, making it big. Contraction, making it small. How you are doing it? Expansion, that you are doing it by heating. You are heating. And contraction, by cooling. So you are changing the size of the axe head by heating. You are making it big. By cooling, you are making it small. So you are making it big to make the wooden handle fix into that, and you are making it small to make the wooden handle fix it so tightly. So all the wooden handles of the tools are fixed in this way. Then they hold the particular blade so tightly. The blade of the axe is held so tightly by the wooden handle because it was fixed when it was hot. Later, by cooling, it contracts and holds, get the good grip on the wooden handle. The same applies to all the other tools. So in the same way, the same method is applied at some more area, fixing a metal rim to the wheel of a bullock cart. You know the bullock cart's wheel, a bullock cart's wheel, it's like this. So it has got wooden spokes. And at the same time, it has got a wooden rim. If the wooden wheel is used exactly like this on the roads, the wood, it comes in contact with the surface of the road and it gets wear. It becomes so rough and it gets damaged so quickly. The wooden wheels, they get spoiled so quickly because the wood is not hard enough to withstand the friction of the road. So that is the reason. On the outer side of this wheel, they will put one more rim made up of iron. That is a metal rim. So the iron, it comes in, actually the iron rim, it comes in contact with the road, not the wooden rim. The wooden rim is covered by an iron rim. But how do they fix it? So here also, they should see that the iron rim, it will catch the grip of the wooden rim. It should exactly fit into that and it should be very tight. It should be very tightly holding the wheel. So here also the same method which we have seen in case of an axe and handle. In the same way, the rim, the metal rim or the iron rim, it is heated, so by that it expands. The expanded rim is fitted to the wheel and cold water is poured onto that. Immediately it becomes cooled and contracted. So the contracted iron rim, it fixes to the wooden wheel so tightly. So that is the application of making use of change in a material, right? So we are bringing a change by heating and we are bringing the change by cooling. Here we are reversing the change, right? So reversing the change is sometimes helpful. Where it is helpful, you have seen. Here it is helpful. In this case, it is helpful. Reversing a change is helpful. But already I told you that we cannot reverse all the changes. Only some changes can be reversed. Some changes, they cannot be reversed. Let us see some examples. So now here we have some more examples to understand what kind of changes can be reversed and what kind of changes cannot be reversed. Now here we have a candle. So candle, you have lit a candle. So the candle burns and some of the wax flows down. However, you leave it there. After some time, what happens is that the candle, it becomes very small. There is a change in the size of the candle, of course the shape. So the size of the candle is changed after some time. Now can you make this candle back to the original one? Is it possible? You have taken some candle wax in a bowl, right? And you heated it. You heated the candle wax, it melts. Can you make the melted wax back to the wax again? Yes. Here, if you heat the wax, it melts, it changes the state from solid to liquid, and if you cool it, again it will turn into wax. In this case, it is possible to reverse it. But whereas in this case, once you burn the candle out completely, you can't get it back. So here, you cannot reverse that. The second one, ghee. If you melt the ghee, it turns to liquid. If you cool it, it becomes a solid, at least a semi-solid. So that is heating. It can be reversed. You can make. You can. The change in the shape or the state of the ghee can be reversed. But if you have taken the ghee into a diya, here you have poured the ghee and you lit the diya. After some time, the ghee is burnt. Can you get back the ghee? No, it's not possible. The next case, you have taken incense sticks. What you call it as agarbatti. So you have lighted agarbatti. After 10 minutes, after 15 minutes, you see that no agarbatti, it's all burnt to smoke. So can you get back the agarbatti? It's not possible. What happened to that? It's changed to some smell. It's changed to some smoke. The agarbatti, incense stick, is changed to some smoke. There is a change which you cannot reverse it. Take some salt water. Take a glass of water and add some salt. You mixed the salt in the water in the previous lesson we have seen. So you made it into salt water. You changed it, that the salt disappeared. So this is a change. But is this change reversible? Yes, of course. You can boil the water to get back the salt. Of course, you may not exactly get the same in the same form how it was earlier, but you can retain that. Okay. Now, take some milk, add some curd. Taking some milk in a bowl and adding some curd every day, your mother does this to make you curd, to prepare the curd. She warms up some milk and adds some sample of curd. She puts a lid and keep it aside from 3 to 4 hours. Then the milk is turned to curd. Milk, when it is added with some curd sample, it changes to curd. You know the properties of milk and curd, both are entirely different. Milk taste is different, look is different. Curd taste is different, look is different. So there is a change. What is the change? The milk changes to curd. Right. So, here the question is, can this change be reversed? Can you make the curd into milk? No, it's not possible. In this case, we cannot reverse this change, right? So, this is not possible. This is possible. This is not possible. This is not possible. This is possible. Right, okay. So, melting of candle, it can be reversed. Melting of ghee can be reversed. Burning of candle cannot be reversed. Burning of ghee cannot be reversed. Burning of incense sticks cannot be reversed. And making the milk to curd cannot be reversed. So here, by these activities, we have observed that there are certain changes which cannot be reversed. So basing on this, we can categorize or classify the changes. In your higher classes, when you are classifying the changes, you can take this categorization. On basing this, what is that? Changes that can be reversed, changes that cannot be reversed. Reversible changes, irreversible changes. On basing this, you can classify all the changes. Yes, this change is reversible. This change is irreversible. So in such a way, you can go for a classification. So that is what the idea that we have to get from the lesson, changes around us. If you like this video, please
Please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.